Everyone, welcome to programming knowledge. So I again welcome you all to programming knowledge. So guys, this is the GitHub link of my repository, so you can download or clone this project. I've defined below the instructions how you can run this project on your local machine. So I again welcome you all to programming knowledge. So let's get started with this tutorial. So basically, in today's tutorial, what we are going to learn, we are going to sorting the data by count of votes. In this tutorial, we are going to sort the data by values in order to see the data from highest number of votes to lowest number of votes. Okay, basically we are going to sort the data by values in order to see data from highest number of votes to lowest number of votes. So basically we will implement our algorithm and we will learn how we can apply this on our Django project. So basically we will learn something on this. So suppose we take a random string, hello world, python programming. I hope this is fine. Okay, so we would create a data structure dictionary which would store the frequency of characters. I hope this is fine. So what we can do for ch and s, I hope this is fine. If ch and d, if the character is already in dictionary, then I would do d of ch is equal to d of ch plus 1. So I would increase the frequency. Increase frequency. Okay. Else d of ch is equal to 1. Okay. Initialize for first occurrence. Okay. We have done this before. Okay, so this was pretty easy. So let me do one thing. Let me create a function, define print data d. So here i is key and d of I is value. Okay, and I would do for I in d, print I comma d of I, and here's the end. Okay, so this is a separate function, and let me here print d. I hope this is fine. Okay, here you can see I made a mistake. Let me do print data here. So I had made a function for this purpose only. Yes, here you can see I have different characters. So let me, I have different characters. Okay, h has a frequency 2, e 1, but this data seems to be very unsorted data. So we will sort the data. Okay, so how do we do that? So we will carry on this. Okay, let me do one thing. Let me remove this. I have created variable a. Okay, so a could sort by key in ascending order. Okay, so a is equal to sorted d dot items key is equal to lambda. We have to make a comparator function, lambda x and x of 0. So here I mean to say that I would sort by key. Okay, and I have to typecast this as dictionary. Okay, sorry for this. I have to typecast this back to dictionary and do print data a. I hope this should work. So yeah, now here you can see that I had sort, empty space. Okay, so this is in ascending order by keys. Please check, this is by keys. A is a key, D is a key, E is a key, G is a key, H is a key, I is equal to a key, L is equal to key, M, N, O, P, Q, R, and W, Y, all here are keys. It is sorted by keys. Okay, I hope this is fine. Okay, let me do another thing. Let me do sort by key in descending. Okay, so this is going to be very much same. I would comment this out. So what I can do, I can copy this and do this as b and print data b. So any change I have to make here? Yes. This is a reverse is equal to true. I hope this is fine. Okay, reverse is equal to true. Now here you can see it has sorted by keys in reverse order by key. Y is a key, W is equal to key, T is equal to R, P, O, N, M, L. All are here keys, but has been sorted in reverse order. Okay, now we'll do the same. What we can do now? Sort by value. Okay, so we would do the same. Okay, sorry for this. I would do this as C, here as C, and here 2 by values. What we can do, I'll remove this. So here 1 means x of 1 means I'll sort by values here. Okay, so let me do run this. Okay, I'll comment this out also. So here you can see that now I have sorted by values 1 1 1 1 1, 2 2 2 2 3 3 4. This is by values. Okay, this is by values in ascending order. Now the very much same thing in descending order. This was in ascending. Okay, and this is now D. I would copy this, and in the very much same thing, reverse is equal to true, and I'll do print data D. Now here you can see that yes, sorted by values in reverse order. So this is the same thing we are going to implement on Django service, Django server. Okay, so what we can do, we'll move to our page. Okay, this is the result table, and what we can do, href, okay, class is equal to button primary, any button you can choose, sort data. Okay, we are going to sort data. Okay, so sort data. Let me say descending, sort data in descending order. Okay, now we'll define a URL, path sort data. I'll implement a function views dot sort data, and name is equal to sort data. Okay, so I hope this is fine. And I'll have to define a URL here, percent URL sort data. I hope this is fine, and then again a percent URL and close the bracket. Okay, so I hope this is fine. And let me check it on my server. But this won't work right now. Actually, this is throwing an error. Def sort data request is a parameter, and return pass. Okay, let me check it. Till now, is it working or not? Okay, so I hope this should work now. Okay, return. Okay. I made a mistake. Sorry. This should be pass. Okay. So now what I can do? Okay. I'll move to the link localhost:8000. Okay, and now to the voting app /voting app. Okay, so here you can see sort data in descending order. I hope this is fine. So what you can do, we are going to implement this very much same logic. Okay, to the rendering part, this should be same, I guess. Okay, this should be same. So I will copy the code. Okay, I hope this is fine. And global count is equal to global count. I hope this is fine now. Okay, but we need to implement the access the global count. Since don't confuse yourself, I'm defining keyword global. So this is a keyword global count. So I'm accessing a variable that is global. Okay, So global count. So what I will do? I will do global count is equal to dictionary, then again sorted. Okay, global count dot items. Okay, and then we are going to sort by value. Key is equal to lambda x of 1, then reverse is equal to true. I hope this is fine. Okay, we will test now. We will test this application. This is Python. I'll submit here. So Python has one mode, 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10, okay, 11 12. Okay, here you can see the Python has 11 modes. Let me do C. okay, till now what we have not clicked on this button. Okay, C is 3 4 5 6. Okay, some Java. Let me submit here. 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, Java has 10 words, so we might soon JavaScript. Okay, so JavaScript has 9 words. Okay, now I'll click sort data in descending orders. Okay, now you can see the magic. The data has been sorted in descending order, 12 10 9 7. Okay, so because we were able to implement the logic on the server side and get it rendered on the front end part, so data has been sorted by values. Okay, so you can try out more in such a way. Okay, we can do anything. Suppose I'll do Java here. Okay, Java has 11 words. Okay, let me introduce a new language, SQL. Okay, SQL has one word. Now SQL has 4 4 5 6 12. Okay, 15 17. Now SQL has more words than Python, so I'll do sort data in descending order. Again, you can see the SQL is now on top since it has 17 words. So you can implement your logics on your server side and get it them on front end. So that's a good part of the application. So in the next tutorial, what we are going to do? So what we are going to do? You can try any of the applications. So let me do another check. Python here has 13. So 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So Python has 23 words. So I'll do sort data in descending order again. Python is back on top. So I'll catch up in the next tutorial. We start on database connectivity, how we can connect our application to the database. We'll start a new application and implement how the basic database logics we can build. So thank you guys, thank you so much. I'll catch up in the next lecture. Thank you guys.